morning children, welcome back to the English class. Now, second unit, second lesson. First lesson we have completed that Oliver asked for more. In that lesson, what did you learn? About Oliver and such orphan boys, how they are suffering in the outside world. Such kind of problems we see everywhere. If we see, what do we do? What should we do? So how should we respond for such problems? Such kind of problems are social issues. That means problems in our society. Our unit deals with the social issues. So in that lesson, we have known about Oliver, how he was suffered. He was really tortured. Not only he, the boys who are in the workhouse really were tortured by the officials. They were starved. They were tortured. Finally, they wanted to ask if he asked, he was ready to be sent out of the workhouse. See that. Comparing with such kind of kids, how lucky we are. Comparing with such students, such children, what kind of lives do we have? Really, we are gifted. We are gifted by your parents are always to the back of you to eat, have something. You eat breakfast, have your lunch, have your supper, have your snacks, like that. So don't neglect such kind of things, because our parents are really gifts of God given by God to us. So seeing the lesson, if you have learned that, so that's good. That's the moral of the lesson. We have to know such kind of story. So the value of the parents and the value of the food also. Not only the value of the parents and the value of the food also. How valuable, how precious the food we are given. Whatever the food given to us. So here again, another such kind of people. People not. These are also about the children. In this whole unit, how children are suffering with the social issues. So here one more social issue, that is child labor. Children who are under 14 should be only in the, not only for 14 years, should be only in the school, not in the work. But if you see anywhere such kind of children, what do you do? You have to inform the 1098. Dial free call. We have to call them and we have to inform, and we should save such children. See, let us how they are suffering. So the child labor are suffering. Here our author, Elizabeth Barrett Browning. She was born in 1806 and died in 1861. She married to Robert Browning and moved to Italy. And most of her poems are dealing with the emotional touch. Most of her writings, not only poems, writings deal with the emotional touch. Here, she deals with the social issue, child labor. For all, say the children, we are well, and we cannot run early, If we care for any meadows, it were merely to drop down in them and sleep. If we care for any meadows, it were merely to drop down in them and sleep. Our knees tremble sorely in the stooping. We fall upon our faces trying to go. And underneath the heavy eyelids drooping, the reddest flower would look as pale as snow. Here, the child labor are telling about their problems. They are saying, so with sorrow, when they are feeling bad. So we are weary. Weary means weak. W-E-A-R-Y. Weary means weak. And we cannot run or leave, as they are working throughout the day. So they became so weak. They became so weak and they cannot run or leap. Leap means jump. They cannot even jump. They cannot even run like you. So other children, that we can't make them go in a straight way because they go always like to go in a playful way. They want to run always. We always share, tell you also, don't run in the corridors. We know how to walk. But you like to run. When you go to playground, what do you want to do? You like to play, you like to jump. But these children, they can't do themselves all these things. They can't even do themselves all these things. They cannot run, they cannot leap. Why don't they do? Because they are very, means weak. All their strength are lost to their work. All their strength, whatever they eat and all their strength are lost only, is lost only to their work. If we care for any meadows, it were really to draw down in them and sleep. Meadows means grasslands. If you see in a garden, anywhere or green grass, what do? Do you want to play there? Isn't it? Yes. You want to play. If any other child sees the green grass and the such kind of park anywhere, they'll go and play there. But what about these children? If they care for any meadows, they don't want to play because they don't have such an energy to play. They like to drop down in them and sleep. They want to take rest in them because morning onwards till evening. What do? We are not only you. Let us take we for us also as an example. If we come, we'll stand here and just work up. That means you will talk, we will teach you all these things. And what do? You will come, you'll have your breakfast, you'll come here, sit here together till in the afternoon or in the middle, you'll take some break and go just for a relief. And afterwards till afternoon, you sit there itself. And afternoon you have your lunch, again till evening you sit. After going home, you relax for some time. And again, you'll sit for doing your homeworks. So the most of the time you sit here. But what about those children? What about those children? They have to work in the hot sun. They have to work. So they have to carry loads. They have to drive the vehicles. That means drag the vehicles or something. Drag the wheels of the iron. In such a way they have to work. So they are really, if they want to say, they become so weak. And if they see any meadows, that means any grasslands, they wanted to sleep in them. Our knees tremble sorely in the stooping. Knees means tremble sorely. Tremble means shiver. Sorely in the stooping. Stooping means bending downwards. Because they cannot even stand like this erect. Why? Because of their weakness. Their legs also becoming tremble. Their knees also become tremble. We fall upon our places trying to go. They cannot even open their eyes and they cannot even lift their faces. And even though they try to go, they cannot even move. And underneath the heavy eyelids drooping. Their eyelids are drooping. Drooping in the sense, just they become closed. If we don't have any sleep the whole night, how do you feel? Or else if you suffer from any fever, the next day how do you feel? You feel drowsy and you want to sleep because of weakness. Because of weakness. And if you go to any function in the late night, if you don't sleep and the next morning if you come and sit in the class, how do you feel? So your eyelids are almost closing. So in such a way, the drooping eyelids, for them every day is a hard work. For them every day they become weary, and every day their eyes they cannot open their eyes because they are always weary. Underneath the heavy eyelids drooping, the reddest flower would look like as pale as snow. The reddest flower. So see that. See if we see your faces are compared to the reddest flowers. So the red shows that we have blood inside our cheeks. So that your cheeks shows that reddest flower. But their faces look like as pale as snow. As pale as snow, because of their weakness, they seem to be weak, as so weak as snow. So their faces also, we cannot see blood and healthy cheeks also in their faces. Seem to be pale, pale faces. So that is next. For all day we drag our burden tiring. For all day we drag our burden tiring through the cold, dark underground. Underground. Through the cold, dark underground. Or all day we drive the wheels of iron. Or all day we drive the wheels of iron. In the factories round and round. In the factories round and round. See that. All day we drag burden tiring. They have the burden of their work. They have the burden of their work. So that they need to work throughout the day. They need to work throughout the day. You feel that you are suffering a lot and you are working hard when you are sitting and doing the homework and under the fan and or else in the comfortable way. Sitting in the bench and sitting in a chair, you feel that you work hard. But see that how much of hard work are they doing? How much of hard work are they doing? They need to work throughout the day. So more than they race, through the cold, dark underground. Where do they work? In the dark coal mines. Coal mines. And all day we drive the wheels of iron. So iron wheels, small vehicles, means they used to carry things, loads here and there. So they used to drag those carts. And in the factories, round and round, round and round, round and round, in the factories here and there, they need to drag those vehicles. Vehicles in the sense they don't run by a machine. They need to drag them or push them. So in such a way, they have to push those transport small vehicles. And those they need to do. They need to work in the factories and they need to work in the coal mines. Coal mines are the dangerous places where it is danger to even the elders. But in such kind of places, the children are also working. Actually, there is a rule, and those who are in the school age under 14 should be in the school. But according to their poverty, family and conditions of their family. In some families, the parents may not, maybe they get divorced, or one of the parents died or something, any other problems due to their circumstances. So they have to work. So it is somehow responsible, but it is not suitable for that age, and they will not be healthy. So there is a rule, particularly children under 14 should be in the school. For this, government has arranged so many facilities for free education and everything. So that if you see anyone, those who are still working outside under 14, we need to inform and we need to help the such children. So that's the poem. First let us see the rhyming words. And leap, sleep, leap, sleep, very merely, stooping, drooping, stooping, drooping, go, snow, round, ground. Round, ground. So these are the rhyming words in this. They read the poem and understand the problems of such children. Thank you, children.